RAM memory. RAM stands for random access memory. It is most fundamental element of computer. Let's see how this RAM plays a very important role in computing, even though it is volatile in nature. Means, it loses all stored data just after power loss. Actually, RAM offers very fast access to CPU, which makes it ideal for processing active tasks and apps. So, RAM is computer's short-term memory, which is used to handle all active tasks and apps. None of your program, files, games, or streams would work without RAM. You must have noticed that, when you open any application, let's say Excel, for the first time, it takes more time in opening. But, if you reopen Excel for second time, it gets open in few seconds. This is because, when it gets open for the first time, a copy is stored in RAM memory as well, and same information is used while reopening it. If you would have checked any time motherboard, there are some slots are there, where we can place our RAM memory. As per our users, we can add more RAM memory to these slots, which enhance the CPU performance. These are DRAM. Actually, RAM is divided among DRAM and SRAM. A dynamic RAM cell is dynamic, meaning that it needs to be refreshed periodically. A static RAM cell does not need data to be refreshed. Dynamic random access memory uses memory cell to store each bit, and each cell is made up of a tiny capacitor and a transistor. This capacitor can either be charged or discharged to hold logic 1 and 0 respectively. Electrically charged capacitor gradually leaks its charge. So, to prevent this charge leakage, DRAM requires external memory circuitry to refresh data periodically. And due to this leakage problem, DRAM consumes more power. The structure of DRAM memory cell is very simple, which consists of single capacitor and a transistor. This allows DRAM to reach very high density, billions of memory cells can be adjusted on single chip. That is why it is very cost-effective, and widely used as computer's main memory, and also used for several other purposes. This memory is located closer to the processor, so that it can easily and quickly access it. There are mainly three types of DRAM, SDRAM, double data rate SDRAM, and error correction code DRAM. Synchronous dynamic random access memory, SDRAM, is kind of DRAM, where the operation of its external pin interface is coordinated by an externally supplied clock signal. You can see SDRAM and DDR data in the diagram with respect to clock pulse. DDR stands for double data rate, and this meaning you can relate with this diagram. The first commercial SDRAM was launched in market by Samsung in 1992 using CMOS fabrication process, and its size was 16 megabytes. Samsung had demonstrated double data rate synchronous dynamic RAM prototype in 1997. And later in 1998, 64 megabytes of DDR SDRAM was commercially released by Hyundai Electronics, which is now known as SK Hynix. Later, it was suppressed by DDR2, DDR3, DDR4, and DDR5 SDRAM, and each release was neither forward nor backward compatible. Means, motherboard specific to DDR2 cannot support DDR3, DDR4, and DDR5. ECC DRAM memory stands for Error Correction Code Dynamic Random Access Memory. ECC DRAM memory is used by professionals and businesses for protect critical data. It automatically detects and correct memory errors. Physically, ECC memory differs from non-ECC memory, in that it has 9 memory chips instead of 8 chips. The extra one chip is to detect and correct error in 8 chips. ECC memory is slower than non-ECC memory as it takes extra time for error detection and correction. SRAM stands for static random access memory, meaning that data need not to be refreshed at all. Static random access memory uses latching circuitry to store each bit. It loses data immediately after the power loss, as it uses latching circuitry to store data. But, this latching circuitry provides very less access time, that is why SRAM is much faster than DRAM, and used for cache memory. Since, SRAM requires more transistors per bit to implement, so its packaging density is comparatively lesser. And, due to this low packaging density, it is costlier than DRAM. SRAM is used where very fast access of data is needed. Like, CPU register files, CPU cache, hard disk buffers, LCD and printers uses SRAM to hold the image to be displayed. SRAM firstly made up of bipolar transistors in 1963 by Robert Norman at Fairchild Semiconductor. Later, in 1964, it was invented with MOS technology by John Schmidt at Fairchild Semiconductor. It was 64-bit MOS P-channel SRAM. Then, again in the year of 1965, it was invented again with new CMOS technology by Benjamin Augusta and his team at IBM. Thanks a lot for your valuable time and attention. Keep learning, keep exploring, keep growing, and stay tuned to this channel.